Okay, listen. We got the new one here.
Yes.
The old, go over there, sit on the bench. Sit on the bench.
Okay.
We got the old one, and we have to be objective, right? That's the most important thing.
100%.
Okay, so I'm created a device, okay? It's kind of weird, but just stay there, okay? Okay, so I've got this. You might recognize this helmet, actually, right? This is the get-in helmet from the i8 video. Can you take that right there?
Yeah.
Okay, those are the earplugs. Those are going to go in, okay? Now, I got a nose thing that's going to go over. I think that's how that works. I don't want you to even be able to smell the difference in the cars, okay? It's very important that we're completely objective.
Okay.
Tie this around so you can't see at all, right?
It looks so good.
Okay, and then this is going to go over the top. Okay, just going to put that down. Okay. All right, so I got one more stage. Don't move. All right, hold this right here, okay? Right there. Hold that there for me, okay? Now, this is really the final, it's the pièce de résistance of my invention, because basically, I want to make sure that every single sense that you have is completely removed. So all you're doing is you're going to be feeling what's going on in the car, okay? Really, it's all about feel. I'm talking about vibrations, noise, harshness, that whole thing, right? James? James?
You're watching Throttleheads. I'm Thomas.
And I'm James, and this is the new 2021 Lexus LS500.
And it costs $140,000 Canadian. But the thing is, I can smell the depreciation from here. So the question came up, how much can you get an older one for?
Yeah, if you want to save somewhere in the realm of, I don't know, $120,000, have we got the Lexus for you?
The 2009 Lexus LS460. It has air suspension, an 8-speed automatic transmission that's scrumptiously paired with an all-wheel drive system, and a big, stonking 4.6-liter V8. And the most important number of all is that it can be found for around $10,000 US, and a hair over that Canadian.
But why be frugal when you can be regal? Even though it doesn't have a V8, the updated 2021 LS500 does have a smooth twin-turboed six-cylinder. It also has air suspension and all-wheel drive, and it represents the new pinnacle in Lexus luxury. From its interior artistry to its external beauty, you get to experience every penny of that sweet, sweet $140,000 price tag fully loaded. Or do you? Let's find out.
If you're new to Throttleheads, we do car reviews, track tests, and quite a lot of messing around. So subscribe and hit the bell.
Okay, so these are technically S-Class competitors.
Yes.
So presence is important.
Very important.
How do they look?
Well, that one has some of it.
It does, yeah. This looks like a car. And it looks old now.
It does look old, but okay.
Like if I was to draw a car when I was a kid.
When you were a kid, that's what it would look like.
This is what it would look like, yeah.
Okay, the problem is especially on the side, there just isn't any styling going on. They didn't actually style it. It just, okay, no. If you look close, there's some stuff. It's very nice. Like the panel
there's
gaps.
Some stuff.
There's some stuff. The panel gaps are like incredibly consistent and very tight. Craftsmanship was very important to them. And they did a very good job, obviously.
But from the road.
But yeah, I have to admit.
You know when you see an S-Class.
Yes.
This just looks like, I couldn't tell you if this was a GS or an ES.
Yes, or a
or
whatever.
An LS.
Yeah.
I honestly, I don't think I could with this, actually.
It's the same thing,
but
yes.
This was a departure. This represented a departure in 2018 because this is actually quite striking.
I just realized that this grille is just an evolution of this grille. It just kind of went, bleh.
Yeah, but if this is Charmander, this is Charizard, because it's giant.
It is huge,
This is a very controversial grille, the hourglass grille.
Okay, so people give us a hard time for making fun of BMW, for saying the grills are too big, blah, 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 but it's not actually that the grills are too big. It's just how they make them proportionally within the front of the car and fit them in.
And this works.
It works because
Audi have made it work too.
It's not offensive to look at. It's big and ridiculous.
But to some people, it is.
But it, yeah, I guess that's fair. That's fair. It's subjective.
I don't see that though. This is facelifted. So
yes.
2021, we got.
This is a facelift too.
Yeah, this was a facelift of this generation.
Yep.
And this is the first facelift of this generation.
Right.
So the lights have been updated to match the LC500.
I like those. Yeah.
And the grille, they've done some stuff with the grille. More exciting though.
Yeah.
This is a new colour that okay. took years to develop, apparently.
Okay.
It's called Silver Illusion.
There All right.
are dozens of us, Michael. And it's special because they've done it to, so it looks like the moonlight reflecting on a clear lake.
That was the first thing I was going to say right. when I saw immediately moonlight on
so
a clear lake.
So the result, obviously, yeah. is silver. It is a better silver than this.
Oh, come on, whatever. I mean, this is, yeah, okay, sure. It's a bit of a better silver. There's some, you know, iridescence in it or
no,
whatever.
It's got lovely wing mirrors. I like the styling yeah. of this. And if I think of it versus the, actually, it hasn't got as much presence as the G90.
No, it doesn't.
The Genesis. But no. it does, I think it's a prettier car than the 7 Series.
It is definitely a prettier car than the 7 Series. Yeah. And it has as much road presence as an S-Class, no question. The problem is that, as you say, it just doesn't look any different than the rest of the lineup.
No.
Not that one does either. I don't know. It's
I'm
just a bigger
curious.
Car.
I haven't been inside this one.
All right, well, it's, okay. Get excited. Yeah. Okay. Before, no words. Listen. They put a lot of work into this interior. Okay, listen. This right here is a special red wood that all comes from the same tree so that the grain is consistent. That's a very important thing.
That would have been my complaint if they used a different wood.
Immediately, that's the problem,
but this
yeah.
This is important. This is a huge part of why you get a luxury vehicle. And the question we're trying to figure out today is, if you go far back in time, how much are you really not getting?
Well, you're not getting an infotainment that looks like it was made in this century.
But it is touchscreen.
That's true. It's the yellow, like non-shiny. It's not good. But at least yeah. it's a full screen, and there's a full backup camera, which is really nice. But okay, but there's really, really fundamentally important things here. First of all, the seats are incredibly comfortable. There is tons of room here. Okay, the steering wheel is very, very nice. The gauges are easy to read, and everything is a switch, like to an extra degree. Check these out. Okay, look at those. How neat is that, right?
They've left that behind.
That's right. Now, and check this out too. When was the last time you saw a physical switch for suspension settings? So I can select sport, like with a physical switch, and then when I get in the car, it's always there. Also, Mark Levinson stereo in this, it's brilliant.
For the time.
No, it's just if brilliant full stop.
You haven't heard that one.
Okay. Also, rear sunshade, look at that. You need that in a luxury car. We'll talk more about the back seats when we drive it, right? But I mean, this is pretty nice. It is pretty nice.
It's pretty nice.
Yes.
Yeah. Bit dated. The problem is Lexus is always like a generation behind. So that when you get into one a few generations ago, it's one degree
extra.
Generation,
yeah. I mean, the fit and finish is still very good. Like, there's no creaks in this armrest whatsoever. And like a brand new S-Class armrest creaks, right? So that's worth saying.
It's quite nice in here. One thing that they didn't do back then, or didn't have the ability to do, was go for like a visual masterpiece. It was like, here's some nice wood, here's some good ergonomics.
Yes, well, they didn't artistically style it. It was just a car. This is only 10 years ago,
but
right?
That is something that they've done in the new one.
Okay.
All right, so these have soft close.
Oh, yeah. I forgot.
Which the old one doesn't.
Right.
Although maybe that's a package.
Well, there is one package above that in terms of luxury, which gives you some like backseat stuff. And,
so this is crazy optioned out.
This one is.
There's a $36,000 package on here.
A $36,000 package.
Yes.
So like the price of a Civic.
Or three of those. Yeah.
For just the package.
But the package comes with a lot. Okay. Including Android Auto and Apple CarPlay.
Wait, hold on. Sorry. You have to get a $36,000 package to get Android Auto.
No, I think you can get that in a smaller package. But this package, I just mean that finally you have a way of getting Android Auto in Lexus/Toyota.
Oh, wow. Finally. Okay.
Anyway,
yeah.
So this is the Omotenashi interior, right?
The what?
Omotenashi.
Omotenashi.
No. It's the onomatopoeia.
We'll put the
interior.
Word up. We'll put the word up.
Yeah.
It's Japanese.
So it's for. It's,
what does
it's,
it mean?
It's something to do with hospitality.
Oh, hospitality. Yeah.
I don't know why you'd want to be in hospital, but it is very nice in here.
Hospitality.
And they've used Takumi craftsmanship. So the Takumi artists have.
You really studied up, eh? You've got these words down.
Mate.
Yeah. Okay.
So one of the biggest things,
are
these doors. This is the Kariko glass. There's a few options.
Okay.
This is by far the best I've seen on the, on the website. There's another one where there's like flames and black. It doesn't look nearly as good.
No, I will say this is stupendous.
It's stunning. And it's even on the rear doors, it's an even bigger piece of glass, so it's even more stunning.
No, I love it. Yeah. And then this is like this kind of like fab. These are physical folds in fabric.
It looked like it was leather when you look at it like online, but in reality, it's like curtains.
I feel like I read that this has something to do with like
origami.
Like yeah, it's origami patterns. That's the idea. Okay. That's the Takumi.
No, this is one of the nicest doors I've seen.
So that's what I mean. They've done art. But one of the biggest changes for this update is that we now have a touchscreen. So it's been brought forward. It does work, but it's Lexus, so it's like a generation behind. So because it has Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, I don't care about the rest of the infotainment. Yeah. And the reason I say that is because if you have graduated to Apple CarPlay or Android Auto, you cannot go back.
Yeah,
it is fantastic. However, because Lexus is stupid, I can't do the heated seats anywhere else, so I have to leave CarPlay and then go into the menus and do all this stuff.
Yeah, so there is a button down here. People say, this is a button. But all that does is get you to the screen where you can then...
And then you've got to click. And then you're still not in CarPlay, so you've got to go menu, and then you've got to click CarPlay.
I'm sorry, right? I have to know, is this actually the only... Okay, go back now. No, go back now. No, hold on.
Yeah.
This is all happening in real time,
anyway,
on camera,
so,
for everybody.
So it is a bit previous gen, especially the way this looks. And if you think the new S-Class is coming in, like there's things that this is fully optioned out, and it doesn't have things that the S-Class or the 7 Series or the A8 does. Like, it has heated seats.
Yeah.
But it doesn't have heated surfaces.
That is actually
And I know you guys are going to say, you know, like, oh, James, how much is too much? Get that silver spoon out of your mouth.
Yeah.
All right. First of all, it's not in my mouth because we're filming, so I put it in my pocket.
You brought a silver spoon.
I just have it on me.
Okay.
But visually, it's very nice in here. The steering wheel looks good. This hasn't got the F-Sport package, but it still looks great.
Okay, you're so ridiculous. Anyway.
It has a 23-speaker Mark Levinson stereo.
Yes,
which is phenomenal.
It is.
Now, I'm not a huge audiophile, so my, like, out of 10 rating, that 10, I know people can divide that into another 10.
Right.
This is just 10 out of 10 for me.
It's just hard 10
it's
out of 10.
It's just a hard 10 out of 10.
Yeah, okay.
It is absolutely phenomenal.
Yeah. Listen, I really like this interior. It's very, very pretty, especially I like this like floating armrest thing.
Yeah, it's got the floating armrest in the back as well.
Yeah, and it has the, this is on the S-Class as well, where this like armrest opens.
Well, you liked the mechanism in the old one.
Yeah.
I'll just show that quickly.
Yeah.
It's kind of cool.
It does this like swoopy thing.
And this allows you to open from both sides.
Wow. Does it creak though? This is a big thing for me.
Not really. There is a bit of movement.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh my goodness.
I think Audi kind of takes it there. But not Mercedes.
No, Mercedes creaks just as much.
Okay, you wanted to run an experiment, but this time without a cushion on my face.
Yeah, I promise you won't pass out. But we are going to now rig you up for a sensory deprivation test.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay, ready?
Yes. All right,
actually, you put those earpieces in. I'm going to avoid the pillow this time so you don't pass out. So you can't smell anything, you can't hear anything, you can't see anything. And I'm actually going to, that's a good look for you actually.
Yeah?
Yeah, you know, I think you could pull that
off. My diving days.
Gonna go down to the club and that's just, what a specimen. Hold on to that, don't do anything yet. Okay, let's make sure that you can't see a thing. Okay, and the helmet on, it kind of is, yeah, there you go. Push it down, attaboy. Okay, so I'm gonna spin you around and then we're gonna pick one of the two cars. You're gonna have no idea which one it is. This is really fun for me, especially this part. Okay, yep, no idea. Okay, there. Oh, yeah, watch out for the door there, you okay? All right, head in.
Lucky I got the get in helmet on.
This is what, this is important. That's why I added it, because I knew. Okay, yep, and here we go, okay. Okay, so. What are you feeling?
Well, my feeling?
Yeah.
Well, I haven't seen my family in a year now, so there's like a sense of longing. And then there's also that sprinkling of anxiety you get from adulthood.
No,
you
know, no. Like, in the car, James, the car.
Oh. It feels really good.
Okay.
Yeah. Really soft.
Yeah, uh-huh.
I haven't felt any gear shifts yet.
Okay.
I'm sure we have shifted.
Yeah.
The way it's handling the ride, I mean, God.
What would you do if I told you we're at highway speeds right now?
No.
Yeah.
No.
Pretty good, right?
Wow. This is how every car should be experienced. In fact, this is how every passenger should be equipped, just so you haven't got to talk to them either. How much happier would Uber drivers be if all their passengers were just
We're
like
forced this? To wear the sensory deprivation helmet by Throttle House? We could make a fortune.
Yeah, this feels really good.
Okay. No vibrations. It's obviously noise. You can't really hear.
Like if you told me this was a Maybach or an S-Class, I don't think it totally achieves Rolls-Royce status, Because the Rolls-Royce, as you said, it feels like you're up on plane as a boat.
Yes.
I can't even feel vibrations or...
Okay, interesting.
But there's just, I can feel the impact so ever slightly, but yeah. This is really nice.
All right, well, let's switch cars. Okay, and out you go, come on, yep. All right, remember, feel in your head what you felt. Okay, spinning.
What's the point of spinning? I know it's the
other
one.
It's just fun for me, that's why I'm doing it. Watch out. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, in you go.
I hate Lexus.
Yeah. Feet in. All right, here we go. Number two.
Okay.
Yes.
Oh, interesting.
Interesting.
So.
Okay, what do you?
So they both have air suspension.
Yes.
Incredibly comfortable.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, just so relaxed. Like, I don't, whether this is the old one or new one, the fact that one of these rides like this for 10 grand is insane.
Yeah, that's right.
All-wheel drive, Toyota reliability, like, oh. But yeah, I can feel engine under my feet.
Okay,
the body motions of the car.
What about any transmission shifts or anything like that?
Shifts are really good, actually. I'm not feeling the shifts.
This is fun. This is very unique. This is a good test.
Yeah, it's the body motions are just, there's just a bit more body motions going on in this.
Okay, interesting.
It's not quite as floaty, it's not quite as on a cloud.
Interesting.
Yeah, fascinating. Time to guess?
Time to guess. Moment of truth. Moment of truth. Is this what science feels like? Okay, out you go. All right, I'm gonna spin you around so you don't know which one you just got out of, okay?
Well, I don't know which one I got out of anyway.
Well, you will if you look.
Stop spinning me!
This is just part of the science experiment.
I'm on a dreidel.
Okay. Oh, all right, take your everything off. Okay.
All right. Oh, yeah, sorry. It's from my old job.
No, it's my old job.
Okay.
Okay. All right, so. First of all,
wow!
Welcome back to the world, James.
Oh God!
Okay, so which one of those was more comfortable as a passenger?
First one.
The first one.
First one.
Which one was which car?
I would like to say that the first one's the new one.
You are correct.
Okay.
Well done.
It's more like it's marginal.
Yeah.
But that you can the thing that kind of gave it away was the insulation from the engine.
Oh, okay.
So, like, I felt the vibrations under my feet.
Yes.
In the old one.
Yeah.
But in the new one, I was just completely isolated.
But the rides were
so
similar.
So similar.
Interesting.
It felt like this suspension is as good, but just 11 years older.
Oh,
like,
okay.
In its prime,
it would have been...
Like you, it would have been just, you know...
But not anymore.
Not anymore.
It's kind of old and fat.
Yeah, 11 years later.
Yeah, okay. That's fair. Should we actually review them now?
Yeah, let me drive you in the new one.
Okay.
Ah, feels good to be able to see again.
I bet.
Yeah.
Okay, just a quick thing back here. First of all, why don't I have any headroom?
I don't know.
It's messing up my hairdo, man.
I know.
It's cramping my style.
I remember the 7 Series having like booster feeling seats. Yeah,
what is this? What is happening? Okay.
But I didn't have an issue with headroom in that.
Is it? Am I right in saying that I can't adjust the seat with a physical button?
There's no physical button.
I actually have to go into this.
You have to go into that screen, which even itself is not that great.
Okay, so wait, no, what does that do? What is that?
Lexus say that this does 4.6 seconds to 100 kilometers an hour.
Does it?
I tested that this morning.
Yep.
I got
5.2. But that's not 4.6.
It's
no.
not 4.6. We're on winter tires. It's a cold day.
Yeah, but there's no wheel spin. There's no wheel. It's an all-wheel drive car. You got nothing, eh?
It's not far off. Twin turbo 6. You can't get the V8 anymore.
Okay.
Is this or the hybrid? So this has 416 horsepower, 442 pound-feet of torque,
wow.
Which is the same amount of torque as the orange Lamborghini Huracan Evo we drove.
These are very important facts being spat out by James Engelsman.
Granted, this is 1,000 pounds heavier.
Yeah.
Over 1,000 pounds
heavier.
It doesn't look like a bullet.
Oh, there we go. Okay, listen,
intuitive is not the word that I would use to describe this car.
No.
Like with the infotainment and then this junk back here. Okay, I've got some screens here. How do I turn them on?
I couldn't tell you. I tried. I'm sure it's very obvious and that we're both idiots.
I'm sure we're both just idiots. But I mean, on the intuitive, we're not that dumb.
Okay, so on further investigation, Thomas is right. We aren't that dumb. You can turn them on from the armrest screen, but it's not obvious, and even then, it just shows an extension of the media screen, not a full smart tablet like most of the competition.
I do have heated and cooled seats back here. That's really nice. This artwork back here is beautiful. And you know what you're right about? The ride is unbelievably good.
If you told me, honestly, I wish we could back-to-back this with S-Class, 7 Series, A8, and we've driven all those cars.
I think that this is just as good as those.
It's definitely as good as
those. And I think when you're on that level of them being that good, you only really notice if something's quite off, right?
Yes, and there's nothing off
about
this.
Although,
even though there's plenty of power, it doesn't sound great. Right? Like it can make up for the V8 in its engine tuning and its gearing, but when it put your foot down,
it just sounds like a 6. And 6s are not really the best sounding engines.
And I can switch it into Sport Plus.
Okay.
There we go.
And what does it do? It pipes fake noise.
We got piped and engine noise,
Okay.
You can feel the mass in the car, but it...
Body control, what do we got? Is it good?
It's fine.
Yeah?
It's fine. It's what I would expect from something that weighs this much. You can get the F... whatever it's called.
Sport.
F Sport.
Yes.
And then that gives you sport-tuned suspension.
Uh-huh.
But I prefer this. I prefer
Well,
like
these
this.
Are all about luxury. The last thing you want in one of these is a sporty variant. That just completely... It's other than, to be fair, the M760... Li with the V12.
Yeah.
That car was unbelievable. It balanced performance and luxury so well.
What, is strange though is that the driving position I'm in is the lowest. And I feel very high. Like there's like this much space between me and the top.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Whereas if I go higher,
okay.
You know, it's just like
yeah.
the lowest isn't low enough for me, just by a hair.
And I don't have much headroom, but what is the headroom issue in this car?
I don't know. They don't want to have
neither of us are tall gentlemen, really. I mean, you're not 6 feet. You're not right. 6 feet, despite what you...
I'm taller than you, though.
Despite what you put in your Tinder profile, you are not.
I don't have a Tinder profile.
Well, you'd like to talk
I have about a very this. Lovely girlfriend who did a COVID haircut for me, and it looks great.
It's not bad. Yeah, she did a great job.
All right, go drive me in the old one.
Okay. In the old one... See, that is the, as you say, the wash of a V8, a 4.6 liter V8.
That's some displacement.
357 horsepower and 344 pound-feet of torque.
Oh,
man. Through an all-wheel drive system.
It's nothing, mate.
Listen, the point is not how much top-end power it has. The point is the sophistication of power delivery. And that is what a V8 gives you. Because feel this. You ready? From pulling away,
right.
You cannot beat displacement. Come to a stop. This is me setting off. Feel that? Right?
Smooth.
It's smooth and it's immediate. And there's a reason why Bentleys and Rolls Royces are like W12s and V12s and they've got 32 turbos attached to them. It's not because they want crazy high-end power. It's because...
They want that displacement.
They want that displacement.
They want smoothness.
They want that smoothness, sophistication, the effortlessness that comes with this.
And it's interesting because now that I'm not in like the deoxygenation tank or whatever we did, I can hear it.
Yes,
and
you can hear
sound,
it.
The sound of that V8 is nicer than that 6.
And interestingly, the owner, my friend Jerry, who owns this car, actually put a hilarious exhaust. It's the only mod on this car. It's an exhaust mod. And what it is it's like a spacer that literally creates a tiny exhaust leak. And all it does is it just lets you hear the V8 a little bit more.
So he's taken steps to make his super reliable old Lexus slightly less reliable?
No, it's nothing to do with reliability.
Yeah, make this have a leak. That's what's going on with Lexus owners. They're so bored of not being able to like see their dealership for a problem that they create problems.
Okay, I see where you went with that. Yeah. But no, it doesn't do anything with that. All it does is it makes it a little bit more V8-ish because the car was so silent to begin with. And to be fair, both of these cars are on snow tires.
It's very nice. And there's more space back here.
Yes, you have way more space. We're exactly the same height. You've sat in the back seat of the other one, and you know how crap that... Also...
And this is the short wheelbase.
This is the short wheelbase. Do you have enough knee room?
Plenty.
Of course
like, so much.
Right? I mean...
I can't get over the price.
$10,000, James.
Yeah, near about $10,000 for, what was it, high mileage 2008 to 2011.
This only has 129,000 kilometers on it, and that's what like seems to be where they all kind of sit on the market. And since it's a Lexus, it'll just go forever. This one has port and direct injection, so you get the performance, and you don't have to worry about, you know, valve gunging up with the, you know, carbon deposits, right? So you just got an ultra-reliable, smooth-as-hell luxury car for $10,000.
Whereas you can get an ultra-reliable, super expensive, also has terrible infotainment for its time.
Yeah, that's
right. New LS500.
Yes.
You know what the thing is here, though? Before I sat in this car, or before today, I was looking online, and you can get the new generation. Granted, you don't get the touchscreen and all the other stuff.
Oh, yeah.
You can get 2018s for like 70 to 80 grand, which is already $60,000 off. So, and I thought that would be the answer, because I didn't realize how much this would have held up. I'm shocked at how good this is.
And how good this is for the money. Like it's
Either way, like these cars, I don't want to say it, but they were born to be bargains.
Yes, and the new one isn't a bargain anymore. That's the whole point. This is frustrating, because when the LS came out, it was literally designed to take down the S-Class for a fraction of the price, and that's exactly what it did. And it just, the new one doesn't, it doesn't kind of stack up to that.
No, the S560 we drove wasn't that much more expensive.
No, was it 10 grand? It's the price of this, more money.
And it has a twin turbo V8.
It has a twin turbo V8, and frankly, better technology, more intuitive. I really do like that car. I think it's pretty exciting, you know, in terms of styling, and like the interior is really cool. But for the money, I just don't know if you're getting enough. Do you know what I mean? Because this, like, look at this. I click this over into the sport suspension setting on my sophisticated air suspension, and, you know, it'll carve corners. It's got a Torsen center diff, all-wheel drive. It's got literally everything that that has. It even has self-park. It's really, really bad. Primitive self-park.
It's a very early version.
Very early. Well, but then the
rear view camera of the new one
isn't much better than the rear view camera.
Awful as well, yeah.
So, I mean, well, what are we doing here? Like, sometimes we were like, oh, I don't know, which one do you get? This one, is this an obvious choice?
Today, I think, for a 14th of the price.
A 14th?
Like, such an absurd difference.
The fraction is
ridiculous. It's almost free compared to the new one.
Yeah, James, of all the cars we've driven, like, how much car you're getting here for the money, this might not just be the bargain of the day, this might be the bargain of the world.
Of the world. All-wheel drive, comfortable.
Quiet, sophisticated, reliable, like what?
The reliable is the kicker, right?
That's really important.
You can't get all the, choose anything else, you don't get the reliable thing as well.
Yeah, this one, but it has that.
But not great fuel economy with a naturally aspirated V8.
Yeah, but the amount of money you save. Do you know how much fuel, $120,000 of fuel is?
The answer is a lot. Like 23 years of fuel, give or take. And since the old one is a Lexus, it'll probably live that long.
So at $140,000, the new one isn't the value option it used to be. It feels like a Genesis G90 fighter, which costs $89,000 fully loaded. An S-Class is more luxurious, an Audi A8 is somehow cheaper, and a BMW 7 Series, while we think not as pretty, is still more car. So in our mind, a used LS is the most sensible way to go. Fortunately, it seems however used you go, you can't really go wrong, which is not something you can say for the others with any confidence.
Oh, and also, if you have yet to hear about the new Extra Throttle House channel, it's a channel where James and I dig a little deeper than the content on the main channel. The LS500 pretty much completes our experience with this generation's luxury sedans, so we took to the conversation couch to discuss our favorites. That video should be out soon on the channel if it isn't already. Either way, I'll throw a link in the description. Go subscribe so that you don't miss it. Thanks for watching.